Hello, welcome, and thank you for joining me for another Crafts with Katie. Today, we are going to be making this super awesome flying bird puppet. Hello.
For this project, you will need bird template, foam sheets, wire, wooden stick, hot glue, tape, and scissors. We are going to start by cutting out our template pieces. To get your bird template, email keyportlibrary@gmail.com. We are cutting a left and right wing and a bird body. Then we'll be using the same piece to make the top and bottom of the bird. You'll see what I'm talking about later. Now that we have our pieces cut, we are going to tape the left wing to one side of the bird body and then tape the right wing to the other side. And here is our bird. And you're all done. Project over. No, I'm just kidding. We have a lot more to do. We're going to use this template on a foam sheet. I picked up this foam from the local craft store. It's 12 inches by 18 inches. You want one that's at least 11 inches long so you can fit the entire bird on one sheet. So once you trace your template, you're just going to go ahead and cut out your bird. With your remaining template piece, you're going to cut out two more body shapes. This will be the top and bottom of the bird. You may notice that one of my pieces is thinner than the other. It turns out that was an unnecessary step, so we'll move on. Add a dab of hot glue to the beak of your bird. Then line up the two beaks together, and you just want to make sure that the rest of the body is also in line as you press it closed. Perfect. Now here comes the real fun part. You see, when you push that top layer of foam forward, you get a bird face. Now I just have to add a little glue in between those two layers. So just put a line right across where your fingers just were, scrunch that forward, and press it closed. Fantastic. Now just add some glue in between the rest of the layer. We're keeping the rest of it flat. So you just have to dab on some glue and push it all closed. Look at this little bird guy. You look great. Now with our bottom piece, we're going to find the center and just cut two slices crossed over each other so that you can easily slide it onto your wooden stick. Great. Now take that bottom piece and line it up with the other one. We just want to make a mark where that hole will be. So take a pencil and stick it right through. Set aside the bottom piece, add a dab of glue to the top of your stick, and attach it where you made that pencil mark. Now take that bottom piece and slide it onto the stick, lining up the two beaks together. Add a dab of glue to the bottom beak, line them up again, and press them closed. Now for the belly of the bird, we're going to do something similar that we did for the head. Add a line of glue right above the tail, scrunch the foam forward, and you create a little bird belly. Now let's add the wires. The wire I'm using is from the floral section of the craft store. It's just your regular bendable wire, but they wrapped it up in craft paper and I thought it looked pretty neat. Okay, so you're going to make a bend on your wire about 2 inches in. Then with your first piece on the opposite end of what you just bent, you're going to wrap it around loosely on your stick. Then do the same with the second, overlapping. So you're just going to wrap it around where you just did, wrap it around, but just make sure that it can move. Now you're going to take each wire and bend them towards the bird, creating a V. As in, very awesome bird. I noticed my one side was a bit too long, so I'm giving it an extra wrap around the stick. You want the ends of the wire to be just inside the wing, not at the tip, just inside. Add a bit of glue and attach your wires to each one of your wings. Again, not all the way to the edge, just inside. Add a little glue, attach the wire.
And just like that, your bird is ready to fly. All you have to do is move the two wire pieces up and down and you have yourself a flying bird puppet. Thank you for crafting with me. I hope you do share your artwork. Tag Keyport Library and Table Setting Is My Life so that we can see what you've created. Special thanks to the friends at Keyport Library for supporting this series. And I hope you all tune in next time for another Crafts with Katie. Until then, bye-bye, birdies.